So a new report from Salon has three former employees of renowned GOP pollster Frank Luntz saying basically his famous focus groups are all a scam. And there are some really choice quotes here. And again, this is from three different employees. Mm-hmm. They say it's a total shtick and a scam. They say that he would, when he would go into these focus groups that use the dial testing.
I love those dials, man.
That if he didn't like the results that were coming in, he would keep yelling at them, keep turning the dials, keep turning the dials. He would screen the focus group participants to make sure he was going to get the results that he wanted. And I love this quote from one of the former employees. Luntz is often on MSNBC these days, apparently, and also on Bret Baier's program on Fox News. CNBC likes him as well. They said, the clowns at MSNBC didn't have a clue about how the focus groups worked or panels or what Frank was doing. The actions were basically contrived. He screened out anybody that isn't going to give the viewers the opinion that Frank, on behalf of his client, is looking for. Somehow, he's able to bullshit people.
That's amazing. It's, I mean, Frank Luntz, you may, you know, I've always thought he was kind of a joker. Although have used some segments, but it was usually when it was based on those live reactions during his Zoom panel. Some of those were actually not bad. But now that you think about it, it's pretty good TV. And maybe that's a problem. Good TV is actually pretty rare in order to manufacture or whatever live. And so if he was consistently delivering some of those segments, you could see why it becomes extraordinarily attractive. He's also made a lot of money. Remember, he is the landlord to House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy, who is paying him a very sweetheart deal in terms of what he's getting, a little room and a nice big house. Also, the craziest thing I've ever seen about Frank Luntz is he has a life-size Oval Office replica in his house, which he gave
here.
A tour. Yeah, I think he played it here.
Yeah, he gave the tour on CNBC, right?
Live on CNBC. And I was like, this is the craziest thing I've ever seen in my life in terms of what rich people do with their money. I mean, it's just unbelievable in terms of what they'll spend it on. And it's all made through politics. He's been an extraordinarily influential person in American politics for, three decades? All the way going back to the 1990s, integral to the Bush administration and the Iraq War, manufacturing consent, and so much more. And so not a surprise in order to see some of this reporting.
And so part of this, I mean, you want to talk about, like, election interference and manipulation. Mm-hmm. There's a long, age-old tactic in politics called a push-pull, where you do a poll where you call all kinds of people throughout whatever district you're running in, and you say, like, would you vote for Saagar and Enjeti if you knew that he was running a corrupt, fraudulent scheme? None of it has to be true, but now in however many people you've called across the district, you've planted the seed in their mind that this might be true. And so, again, it could be wildly inaccurate, totally made up, etc., and this is meant to move public opinion. Well, this is even more on a grander stage because he's on Fox, he's on MSNBC, he's on CNBC, creating these contrived results that people are thinking is gauging real public opinion. And so this becomes a chicken and egg thing because people think, like, oh, this is how everybody else is thinking, and human beings being what they are, they're influenced by that. If they think a race is going in a certain direction, or if they think that a lot of the population is feeling a certain way about a politician, that can impact the way that they're thinking about a race, too. So this isn't just benign, like, oh, he ginned up ratings for these cable news companies. This can actually impact and change the trajectory of a race. So I definitely will not. We did play some of the Zoom segments and stuff. I would not use any of his stuff going forward because it does strike me as true. This was more than one employee. They found three different people who all were like, it's total bullshit. It's a total shtick. It's a total scam. So beware, all.
Here we go.
More Rising for you after this.